Hello! In this post, I want to introduce a completely free and offline TTS that was recently released with a new technology. Unlike other TTS systems, this one uses an intelligent LLM that guides it on how to read each part of the text. This makes the speech sound much more natural and realistic. Installing this TTS is very easy. It only takes 2 clicks. I'll explain everything about this TTS in detail. But before we continue with the tutorial, let's listen to a few samples I generated with it.
We know technology is advancing quickly, but AI is moving even faster. It's already transforming our lives from the way we work and stay connected.
Google has introduced new features for its Android and Pixel phones, including the ability to generate images of people in the Pixel Studio app.
It's been a fairly regular day so far. I woke up, had my usual cup of coffee, and went through my morning routine. The weather is neither too hot nor too cold, just a normal day.
Are you serious right now? After everything I've done, this is what I get. I've worked so hard, put in all my effort, and yet here I am being treated like I don't even matter.
There's absolutely no way this is real. I mean, I never expected anything like this to happen. Not in a million years. How did this even happen? This is insane.
Continuing this tutorial is divided into several parts. You can jump to any section you like. In the first part, we'll talk about the system requirements for Spark TTS. You can use either a CPU or a graphics card that supports CUDA, which means NVIDIA GPUs. Naturally, performance is much better with a graphics card.
Your graphics card should have at least 6 GB of VRAM, and you should have roughly more than 12 GB of RAM. Spark TTS is around 10 GB in size, so you'll need 10 GB of free space. If you decide to use a CPU instead, you'll need a powerful one, along with at least 16 GB of RAM.
To make installing Spark easier, I've downloaded all the necessary files and put them in a zip file. All you have to do is download the file, unzip it, and run Spark TTS. I've included the link to these files in the description. If you have an NVIDIA graphics card with at least 6 GB of VRAM, download the CUDA version for better performance. If you don't have an NVIDIA card, download the CPU version. Although it works on less powerful CPUs, it takes considerably longer. Let me briefly explain how Spark TTS operates. One of the main challenges for TTS systems is determining how each sentence, every segment of text, and each part of a paragraph you provide should be read, deciding which sections to emphasize and what tone to use. Traditionally, many TTS systems employ a pipeline approach that figures out how to read each part. They start by analyzing the punctuation, then examines the sentence structure and grammar. However, Spark TTS uses a single LLM called Qwen 2.5. This large language model understands the text you provide, just like when you input it into ChatGPT, and asks for a reading style or tone for each part. It performs that analysis and then generates something called semantic tokens. These semantic tokens have 2 components: what should be read and how it should be read.
Then, the semantic tokens are sent to the bicodec decoder, which generates the final audio output. When you open Spark TTS, you'll see 2 tabs: voice cloning and voice creation. Voice cloning. This mode lets you provide a short reference audio sample. Spark TTS will analyze the voice characteristics and generate speech that mimics that voice for any text you input. The quality is quite good, just like the examples I played at the beginning of this video, which were created using voice cloning. Voice creation. This mode is used when you don't have a reference voice. Instead, Spark TTS generates a completely new voice from scratch. You can adjust settings like gender, male or female, pitch, and speed to customize the output. This mode is for when you have a reference audio, a voice sample that you provide as a reference. In this case, you input the voice, and the global tokenizer generates a set of tokens that encode the characteristics and qualities of the voice. These tokens capture features such as speaking rate, pitch, speed, accent, and tone. These are called global tokens. The text you input is also broken down into smaller units and converted into textual tokens. Now, these global tokens and textual tokens are passed to the LLM, language model. As I mentioned before, semantic tokens are generated at this stage. These semantic tokens are then sent to the decoder, which finally generates the audio file. However, if you don't have a reference voice, the text is processed in a similar way, but instead of global tokens, a set of attribute tokens is sent to the LLM. These tokens define the characteristics of the voice to be generated, for example, whether the voice should be calm, deep, or thin. The LLM then produces semantic tokens, just like in the previous case. A fine-grained processing step follows, where additional refinements are applied, such as adjusting the speech speed and pitch. These refined tokens are sent to the bicodec decoder, which then generates the final audio file. This is a summary of how Spark TTS works. Before we dive into how to use Spark TTS, let's go over some of its strengths and weaknesses so you can decide if it's the right choice for you. Pros of Spark TTS. No 30-second audio limit. Unlike some other TTS models, Spark TTS doesn't restrict you to generating only short clips. Completely free and open source. Spark TTS is licensed under Apache 2.0, meaning you can use it without any restrictions. Efficient and lightweight. It runs relatively fast and puts less strain on your system compared to other TTS models. Future language training support. There's a possibility that in future updates, Spark TTS will allow custom language training, making it even more flexible. Cons of Spark TTS. Lower sample rate, 16 kHz. The generated audio has a 16 kHz sample rate, which may not be as high quality as some other TTS models. Limited emotion control. Currently, you can't precisely control emotions like anger, happiness, or sadness in the generated voice. You have to use certain techniques to adjust the tone, but future updates might add direct emotional control. Occasional bugs. In some cases, you might click to generate audio but receive no output. These bugs aren't very common, and you may not encounter them at all, but they do exist in this version. All right, let's get started with Spark TTS. I've got two versions of the software for you. If you have an NVIDIA GPU, grab the GPU version. It's optimized to run faster and smoother on your graphics card. If you're using a CPU, no worries. There's a CPU version too, so you can still test it out. How to run Spark TTS on your system. Running Spark TTS on a GPU NVIDIA. First, extract the GPU version. Then, just double-click on Run Spark TTS GPU, and boom! It launches using your graphics card for better performance. Running Spark TTS on a CPU. Downloaded the CPU version? Great, find the file called Run Spark TTS CPU, click on it, and let it run. Depending on your system, it can take anywhere from 10 seconds to 2 minutes to start up. Once Spark TTS is up and running, you'll see the main interface. Exploring the Spark TTS interface. When the software opens, here's what you'll see. Select a reference audio. Pick an audio file as a voice style guide. Enter your text. Type the text you want to convert to speech. Pro tip, if you want better voice matching, try entering the same text as the reference audio. Example, if the reference clip says "Hello World," type "Hello World" in the text box. This helps the AI mimic the voice more accurately. Want to use your own voice? Click the record button and speak. Spark TTS will then generate speech in your voice style. How to control emotions in Spark TTS? Right now, there's no direct emotion control, but here's how you can influence the tone. Write with emotion. If you want an angry voice, make sure your text sounds angry. Use punctuation and emphasis. Exclamation marks, question marks, and phrasing can change the way the AI delivers the speech. By tweaking your text, you can make your AI-generated voice sound more expressive. That's it. You're all set to use Spark TTS. Try it out. Play with different voices and see what works best for you.
The voice creation section is really easy to use. Choose your gender, male or female. Adjust the pitch and speed of the voice. Type your text in the input box. Click Create Voice, and that's...
You can generate a customized voice by adjusting parameters such as pitch and speed.
Once it's done, you can download the generated voice. As you can see, the output sample rate is 16 kHz. If this video helped you, make sure to follow our page. We break down the latest AI technologies in simple language so everyone can learn. Thanks for watching.